Hello, the Story Podcast is here, yeah, we are keeping on track. Okay, so as I promised you today, I choose for you a funny topic, or happy at least. It will be a single life in Egypt. What can you imagine under this topic? Well, it will be, I don't want to say for women, I guess it can be even for men, but because I'm a woman, so it's better to speak about women, right? So, I want to tell you about something which is kind of different from Europe, and most European doesn't understand this point. And that to live alone in Egypt, it's not that good as you could imagine. I'm sure that every European or foreigner simply, okay, I don't want to speak on about European. But for example, if you want to go to Egypt, so you don't have to see a problem that you think I will go to a hotel by myself or rent a room or flat, but I will afford a life by myself in Egypt. Okay, it can happen, even you can afford, I don't say that no, but from the Egyptian point of view, it's not good, not right, okay? Because with this is connected a lot of problem. Because if you are a woman and you decided to live in Egypt by yourself and you don't understand Arabic, you have no idea what other people will say about you. Maybe you'll tell me now, but why should I care what do people think about me? Good way, it's the European way of thinking of foreigner. But come on, we are in Egypt. And if you are want to live here, for example, or visit our country in Egypt, you have to accept the Egyptian rules and the Egyptian style of life and even how the Egyptian people will see you or speak about you. It's really very important because the life in Egypt is based on a good relationship with a people. So, if you wanna be fine with the people here, they have to think good about you. You have to show them your good character, and if they like you, so they are going to help you even after. But if they will not like you, no one will help you in Egypt. And in the time which you will have some problem, and be sure, in Egypt there is always some problem, and you have no background, what you are going to do? So that's why I'm telling you this very important point. You have to really focus now with me on this. So, what they will say about you if you're a woman living alone in Egypt? Honestly, they will tell about that you are not a polite woman. What does it mean? They will think about you that you're kind of, I don't want to say the bad word, so I will say like, kind of easy woman, and that possibly you will exchange a lot of men, okay? And because you are not married, you are free. Okay, I don't say that you're not polite. You can be polite, however. But they will tell this about you. Because a woman alone without men or without a family, for them is clearly an impolite woman. So, take care. And the second point, even if you would like to invite a friend to your home, I mean a man friend, it's not possible. They will not accept it. This is Egypt impossible. I told many times that a friendship between woman and man in Egypt is not exist. Really, it doesn't exist here. They don't believe in this, and it's not their culture. They always say, if a man speak with a woman, so I mean like a closely speaking, so he's interested about her, he's imagining her as his future wife. And because you're a foreigner, you don't know this, you could fall for this. So easy in Egypt simply is one rule which you have to learn, that no woman can stay alone. Like every woman needs a man behind her. It doesn't matter now if it's a husband or a brother or a dad, but you have to have someone, like really someone who protects you, someone who cares about you, to don't let the people speak badly about you, but even harm you, however. But don't think it's only about a woman. It's even about a man. A man living alone in Egypt. It can happen, but also it's not often. Egyptian men are living with a family till he get married. Same as for a woman. In this, it's no difference. Only in some cases, if the family they have some problem, I mean, like some serious problem, it can happen that he could live alone in the end, but it's not that way because easily the Egyptian men are not used to care about themselves. Okay, as a foreign man, for example, you are able to cook and clean for yourself and these things, you have no problem. But Egyptian men have a problem. That's why they are still staying with the family, let's say with the mom who care about him, till he gets married and the wife will care about him. But not only the problem of the cleaning and caring, but simply no one of Egyptians like to live alone here. They really love the family so much, and it's the base of their life, the family. It's the first thing in their life. And actually, it's very good. I agree with this point. It's very beautiful. Because no one likes to be alone at the end, right? And this is the point where I always think, what happened with the foreign people? Why we learned to love to be alone, to stay alone? In a flood and in the life. I think it was a plan of someone, maybe a government, which I don't know, it's just my guessing, how to maybe destroy us slowly. And because the foreign people, I don't say mostly, but a lot of them doesn't like so much family, don't prefer to marry neither children and love to stay alone and build a career. But in this case, I see Egyptian much better because they are right. If I have a good career and a money, for what I have it, if I have no one to share the happiness with. Okay, I'm for example the richest man in the world, but I have no close person to share the happiness with, what I will do with all of the success. But if you succeed and you have the family background and you can celebrate with them and share the happiness with them, it's for me much more beautiful and good way of understanding of life itself. I think it's really good point to stop and maybe think about it a little bit. But my message now is different. Yeah, I want to tell you just that if you think that you came to Egypt and you can live the European life, maybe if you're a tourist for a few days, but if you plan to be here longer time, so be sure you have to learn the Egyptian way of behaving, the Egyptian mentality, the Egyptian standards, okay? And this is the point today which I wanted to remember. You have to remember that the Egyptian people will always, always, always speak about you. No matter if bad or good, but they will speak. So please, my advice is let them speak about you very good way, very beautiful way. Because if they will do this, as I told, all people will help you, all the gates will be open for you, and you can have really a good and perfect life here. But if you will, for example, mock on the people and treat them badly, I speak badly about them and don't want to get in touch even with the people, don't want to see anyone, it will not be a nice life here. Trust me, I experience all of what I say, that's why I speak about it. So learn as much as possible and quicker you can. Okay, thank you for listening. And look forward to another podcast. Bye.